You're a big swim team and you like to order a lot of gear, maybe you ought to check out Swim Outlet Team Division for these reasons. Swim teams receive a 10% discount on bulk orders. Swim teams or organizations get an 8% commission on referred sales. You'll also like their customization services, which is affordable and available at all times during the year for all team gear. With over 50,000 items in stock, you can get most anything you want. Swim Outlet Team Division. You need to try it out. You'll be glad you did.
This is the Morning Swim Show for Tuesday, November 4th, 2014. I'm your host, Jeff Cummings. Joining me today in the Finis Monitor is Kirkland Mawae. He's getting ready to compete in his final Louisiana High School State Championships and hopefully defend his 100 freestyle and 100 backstroke titles. He's been making big strides in the past year, and to talk about all that, let's bring on Kirkland Mawae from Baton Rouge, Louisiana. Hi, Kirkland. It's great to see you. How are you?
Good. Thank you for having me.
It's good to have you. Well, first off the bat, I've got to ask you about this last name, Mawae. It's spelled M-A-W-A-E, but pronounced Mawae. What's the origin of that name?
It's Hawaiian, actually. My grandpa is full Hawaiian, so I get it from my dad's side. Passed it down. I'm lucky to have that name. I like my origin and stuff like that.
Yeah, you probably. I'm not the first person to ask you, I'm sure.
No, I get it and pronounced wrong all the time. It's kind of normal.
And Kirkland, that's a very interesting first name. Do you know why your parents decided to give you that name?
Yeah, my parents are Christian, and so they chose that name based off the meaning, which means the land of the church. And so they like that meaning a lot. It comes from Old English. So
that's very nice. Oh, you definitely have an unusual name and very interesting. It makes for a lot of great stories, I'm sure, over the past few years.
Definitely.
So the high school, Louisiana High School State Meet's coming up in a couple weeks. Getting excited? It's your last one.
Yeah, I am excited. I'm ready to get going.
You got any particular time goals in mind that you want to share?
I mean, I just want to swim pretty fast. I mean, I'm good. I like dropping time. So as long as I get lower than what I've been doing, I'm going to be good.
Well, speaking of dropping times, you've been doing a lot of that this past year. From what I understand, you dropped 5 seconds in the 100 free in a year and dropped 8 in the 100 back. I mean, that's pretty amazing. I mean, have you been surprised by all that?
Yeah. I mean, I feel like I put the work in, and I've always been told you get in or you get out of what you get in, you put in and stuff like that. So, I mean, it's always surprising when you drop time, and it's always awesome when you drop time. So I'm happy with what I've been doing and stuff like that.
Well, I understand you just recently started swimming full time, like less than a year ago. So what does that mean actually for you, swimming full time?
I mean, it's kind of my life now, I guess. So looking back on it, I mean, I never would have thought I would be kind of where I am right now. It means a lot to me. I spend all my week with my family, pretty much, which is here at Callfish. So,
well, that's really good. What prompted the change for you to really start making this, making swimming your sport of choice?
It was actually my high school coach. She wanted me to get better. Right when we moved here, I swam high school, and so she wanted me to get better over to the next season, and I just kind of fell back in love with the sport and wanted to continue it on. So.
Well, I had to make your coach, Jamie Kramer, Crawfish, happy too. He's got you in the pool a lot more now.
Yes, sir, he does.
So 100 free and 100 back, you're going to be swimming that the Louisiana State Meet, correct?
Actually, I'm going to be swimming 100 back and 2 IM.
100 back and 200 IM. Well, that's a great diversity to be able to go from 100 back, 100 free to 100 back, 200 IM. So why did you decide to not do the 100 free this year?
It was more that I decided to do the 2 IM instead of not do the 100 free. Over the past summer, our team as a whole has been training a lot of IM and stuff like that. So I feel like I hopefully can win the 2 IM at state, and I definitely want to drop a ton more time in that and, of course, become more a diverse swimmer. So it's always great when you do 2 IM and do that.
Well, being a diverse swimmer is what it's all about in college swimming. And as we could see there, you're going to be attending Wingate next fall. Congratulations on making that decision.
Thank you so much.
So you're from Louisiana, Wingate to North Carolina. So, you know, obviously you wanted to get, you know, you're going to be pretty far away from home. So what prompted you to choose Wingate?
I mean, academically, it's an awesome school. I like how small the school is. It's around 2,000 undergrads, which is nice. I mean, I come from a college town down here, so I know how the big universities work, and I love it, but I don't think I would fit in definitely at like a university that has 10,000 people at it. And I like the close nature. I go to a school of 69 people in my graduating class, so it's kind of moving that forward. And then I feel like the coach knows what he's doing. I think, and it shows with their results and stuff like that. And they have some really fast swimmers. And when I went on my recruiting trip there, I felt like I really fit in. And that's what I'm most excited about.
Yeah, and they're really good in Division II swimming. They're kind of always right on the cusp there of winning team titles. You know, do you think you could be a part of that, maybe even in your freshman year, being able to contribute right away? Or are you kind of thinking, well, freshman year, get adjusted, and then kind of build into it?
I mean, I definitely hope to make an impact right when I get there. But if it doesn't, I understand. I mean, I'm a latecomer to swimming, but it would be awesome if I could make waves when I get there.
Well, you talk about being a latecomer to swimming, but something I understand you've been doing for quite a while is, and this is something I've never said on the Morning Swim Show, is you are an Irish dancer.
Yes, sir, I was.
You were, so you're not doing that anymore.
No, sir, I hung up my dancing shoes for full-time swimming.
Well, I guess as the sport of swimming appreciates that, but tell us how you got involved in that. It's very unusual for to hear about that kind of thing.
Yeah, so when we lived in New York, my sister got into it. She was around like 4 or 5, I think, and it was just this community thing that we just did. And then from New York, we moved to Tennessee with my dad's job, and then we were homeschooled, so we just kind of needed some kind of PE. And so my parents found this great school. It's called the Kristen Bucky School of Irish Dance. Formerly, it was called that. And I kind of fell in love with it. I mean, the rhythm, the timing, the music, it was just, I mean, that was my life. It kind of consumed it for a good 8 years. And then we had to move here after my dad retired, and I continued it here for a little while, and then, I mean, and so I then I fell back in love with swimming, so I kind of gave it up. But I mean, it was a big part of my life, definitely, and it was hard to give up. But I mean, I don't regret the decision I made.
Did you think you would possibly make a career out of that when you were younger? Did you think you wanted to be an Irish dancer growing up?
When I was really young, I didn't think about it, but like during the time of me dancing, I definitely thought I could become a teacher one day, and that's what I wanted to do. I mean, I competed worldwide, and that was like the beginning of people becoming a teacher. So I mean, if I wouldn't have got back into swimming, I would have continued that and hopefully got my teaching certificate for that.
What's the biggest Irish dancing competition you'd ever been to?
The World Championships. The last one I went to was in Boston. It was about 2 years ago, I think.
Wow, you've been to the World Championships of Irish Dancing. Well, that's very impressive. Congratulations on that. I feel bad that you're now full-time devoted to swimming. It would be interesting to see how far you can go with that. But, you know, swimming is a great sport. Obviously, you know, you know, who knows? Maybe when you're done with swimming, you retire, you can get back into the Irish dancing, and, you know, you can still be a teacher.
Yes, sir. That's what I always think. I mean, if swimming doesn't pan out, I always have something to fall back on, which is really nice, and it's kind of settles me.
Yeah, I would imagine that maybe even while you're swimming at Wingate, you know, there might be, who knows, there might be an Irish dancing club at Wingate for you to join.
Well, it's kind of funny you say that, because when I went up to my recruiting trip, I actually found another person on the team that he was an Irish dancer, or used to be an Irish dancer. That was really cool when I saw.
Well, I think we might have something going on here. Division two swimming Irish dancing club somewhere. That might be fun for you to start. But it is great that you continue to swimming and definitely start devoting your full-time attention to it. It's definitely working out and showing the results. Tell me about, you know, what you think has been the challenge for you making this a full-time thing.
I think the biggest challenge would probably be coming in late. I mean, all the people I swim with have been swimming since they were like 4 and 5 in age groups and stuff like that. And I mean, I started when I was, I had the fundamentals down when I was younger. But I really didn't start picking up my training until 2 years ago or something like that. And so I think that was the biggest thing to overcome. And I feel like I've kind of, I don't feel like I'm playing catch up anymore. I feel like I'm where I need to be right at this moment. And I'm just ready to progress as far as I can go.
Well, that is great to hear. Well, I am really, I'm really excited to learn more about you, Kirkland. It's just really interesting. Like I said, I don't think I've ever had an Irish dancer on the Morning Swim Show, so I like to check things off my list. So I thank you for that. Before we let you go, though, we're going to submit you to the final five. These are five questions we ask all of our guests on the Morning Swim Show. And first question for you is, which swimming celebrity would you like to trade lives with for one day?
I think Tyler Clary. That would be pretty cool to be in his shoes for a day.
Yeah, maybe even the race car driving day if he were doing one of those.
Exactly, that would be cool.
Which non-swimming celebrity would you like to trade lives with for a day?
I know this is a fictional character, but I would honestly say Tony Stark from Iron Man, just because he seems to get everything, and he's a billionaire, so... That counts.
Yeah, that counts, and you're probably not the only person that thinks that. Besides this current year, what's a year of your life that you would like to relive?
My freshman year, back in Tennessee. I definitely want to relive that.
Okay. What's your favorite movie?
Star Wars. I mean, I don't know which one to choose. I like all of them, honestly.
Even the prequels?
Yeah, my friends make fun of me all the time because I say A New Hope is my favorite Star Wars, but I only like it because of the arena scene. But I mean, I like all of them. Yeah, honestly.
They are all awesome. You're right. What's your favorite season?
Fall. We don't really have fall here in Louisiana. It's mostly just summer and winter. But when I get to go to states that have fall, like North Carolina, of course, I like that season the best.
Yeah, you'll definitely see some seasons in North Carolina, that's for sure. Well, Kirkland, thank you so much for joining us. Congratulations on picking Wingate, and good luck at your state meet in a couple weeks.
Thank you so much.
All right. That's going to do it for this edition of the Morning Swim Show. Be sure to check out our high school channel in a couple weeks to find out how Kirkland did at the Louisiana State Championships. I'm Jeff Cummings. Thanks for watching.